radiation. Does radiation make things larger? And what about photosynthesis and the whole business about animals eating any kind of plant that has been subjected to radiation?
Okay, well, radiation can make things, can make cell growth faster, but that doesn't produce giants, that produces what we call cancer. So, in order for something to get big like that, it would be a very sophisticated process. A whole embryology and growth series would have to work properly, and just a little bit of radiation attacking a few cells isn't going to do that. And similarly, if radiation affects a leaf that a grasshopper is eating, it's not going to somehow inherit the mutations that are in the leaf. It doesn't work that way. Only if there's some kind of radiation still on the leaf from the original particles that are affected, that way it could affect the grasshopper as well.
He just told Spider-Man to put
that comment.
There's
a lot of
science fiction in this film. There's a lot of Spider-Man death.
Mm-hmm. What about when the reporter went to the entomologist and sought his advice because, as she put it, scientists think in terms of cause and effect?
To some extent, yeah, that's true. I mean, as scientists, we try to explain what we see in the world around us. So we make observations that we try to explain by sometimes doing experiments and sometimes by looking at the evidence that's already taken place in terms of characters that we see in animals and stuff.
Is it possible that one of the things they might have gotten partially right in this film is the codependence of plants and insects?
Yes, I think that part is very true. Plants need insects to pollinate them, and a lot of insects eat plants, so there is a strong codependence.
Well, I think I've asked enough questions for the time being. Is there any